Hello friends, welcome to Android Gateway YouTube channel. In this tutorial, you will learn how to pass Transcribe Me audio test. I already transcribed first two part of Transcribe Me audio test. This is the third part of audio test. So, first of all, you must read this Transcribe Start Guideline. This will help you during the exam as well as after the exam when you pass this audio test and you get the job. So you must read this transcription guideline rules. This will help you a lot during the exam as well as when you got the job. So I already transcribed it. Let's start the audio test of Transcribe Me third part.
Described in the natural science methods and ways of doing things that are useful. But then obviously a lot of research money is going into these things which are apparently much less useful.
Useful isn't quite the point. Insightful, I think, is the thing. You know, a lot of things are worth doing even though they're not useful because they give you understanding. Mm-hmm. Understanding is a value in itself.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
These things don't even give you any understanding. All they do is maybe fool people or something like that.
So what I'm wondering is there a connection, in your opinion, or what do you think of the idea that there might be a connection between the kinds of things that get funded that lack real progress in science and the kinds of things that get funded in the economy and politics and so on?
Well, first of all, I don't regard this stuff as science. Most of it doesn't seem to me science at all. It seems to me kind of hype, or maybe sort of badly organized engineering or something like that. But within real science, you know, people make mistakes, but I think there's sort of reasonable interaction about what's the right thing to do on sort of a rational basis. You know, there's self-advertising and power trips and so on and so forth. But when you move towards subjects that have more intellectual substance, you move towards more integrity. Not because the people have better genes, but because nature is a hard taskmaster and it doesn't allow you to fake. You know, so the more you understand, the harder it is to fake. So you get more honesty.
Thank you very much. I'd like to close with this comment. If somebody makes a computer that can do the sort of analysis that you do, then I'll believe they've achieved something.
Don't forget, you can't design programs that do simple things like talking like a 2-year-old.
Hi. I wanted to raise a point with the chess playing computer again. I might be looking at it the wrong way. To say that a computer plays chess but it doesn't model human thought makes it useless.
It would be useless even if it did model human thought. Maybe it would be interesting, but it would be useless if it modeled human thought.
But isn't it possible, if you look at it from a different viewpoint, to say, can we design a machine that can solve a problem within a limited domain that humans have difficulty with, and in which case I think a chess-playing computer does very well.
There's no point to designing programs in general that will solve problems within limited domains. It's like an engineering problem. I'm saying, wouldn't it be useful to build a big machine? If you build a big machine that helps you make a bridge or something, yeah, then it was useful. And similarly, there's no point in constructing a program that will solve some arbitrary problem. That you can do, undoubtedly. You can do it in your spare time if you've taken the first semester of computer science to write a program that'll run through some decision procedure for some simple part of mathematics.
Sure.
Once you learn the decision procedure and you learn how to program, you can do it. So what?
Okay. Well, my point is that it seems kind of selfish to think that the only intelligence that we can have or the only way we can solve very complex problems is to use the human brain.
That's not true. Nobody believes that. You know, you want to do weather forecasting, you're not going to use the human brain. You'll use all kind of statistical analysis of weather patterns going way beyond the human brain. You know, you want to solve a particular problem, you look for the best methods of doing it. But that's because you have a goal. You want to solve that problem for whatever reason. See, the reason you try to understand what humans are doing is because you're interested in human beings. If you're interested in human beings, you want to understand what humans are doing. If you're interested in solving a problem, you try to solve that problem. If there was a purpose to playing chess, you know, if there was a purpose to winning chess championships, there's zillions of possible algorithms. You make a slightly different game, you make up a different algorithm. There's no point to it.
I think there is a point.
Well, what's the point?
The point is that we know if it's doing a good job or not.
No, but look, we can set up endless numbers of tasks, and we can design machines to do those tasks, and we can do it forever. There's no point. Sometimes it may turn out that having tried an arbitrary task, you'll get something of some value, but you got to show that.
So, friend, this is the audio test of Transcribe Me Part 3. I hope this will help you a lot, and please subscribe my channel and also like this video. So this is the video for today. I hope you like this video, and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. See you soon.